Hi everyone! In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a backend using Manifest. Whether you're working on a mobile app, a website, or even a business tool, Manifest can be your backend. We will try to do it in a few minutes, so let's go. So what we are going to do is create a Manifest backend for a simple recipe website. We will manage the content directly from the provided admin panel, and then we will use any API client just to see our API. Okay, so we are here in a random project, which is my recipe website. And we'll start by installing Manifest by running npx add manifest. So why it's installed, just a few words about Manifest, which is a backend as a service that fits into one YAML file. You just have to define it in this file and you get a complete backend with all the logic, the storage, the data, and an admin panel. So you don't need to manage security, authentication. In short, it allows you to have a very complete backend quickly. And it runs with SQLite by default, which is perfect for local development. You can switch to Postgres or MySQL for production. Okay, it's installed. So we will open it on VS Code. We see here our application with the backend, with the YAML file. And a backend template that is listing owners and cats and some content for a homepage. So we can see our cats have a name and age. They belong to owner. Let's run it to see what we get. npm run manifest. Okay, so we got an admin panel and an API documentation. If I launch my admin panel, I can login, see all my content. So I have mock data. I can see my owners, cats. I can create cats, edit them, remove them. And then I can see an API documentation, which is listing on all my endpoints. And I can see how to use those endpoints. Now let's create our backend for our recipe website. So I have here my YAML file for the pet application. I will just replace my title, recipe website, or app. And I will replace, I don't need to manage owners and cats. I need to manage recipes. Okay. So I will remove the cat and the homepage properties, and I will go just quickly to the documentation, which is here. And I can see for the entities that I have a lot of property types that are explained. In our case, we will start just by add a title. So the title of the recipe, and then we will need a description, but maybe not a text area. A rich text could be better. Yes, we will need ingredients too, we'll need instructions too. We will need image, but not a simple image. We want here, like here. We want to display a small image for the list or for the mobile version, and a large one for the detail page of my recipe. What else? I will need to add my prep time, which is a number, my cook time. I don't need total time. Maybe I will finish by just some notes if I need just to put, for example, some link or more information. And that's all. My recipe backend is here, is ready. So if I go to the admin panel, I can see here the recipes. I will create one, okay. And I will add just a photo. Okay, so I have my first recipe. If I go here, I can see the recipe with the prep time, the cook time, the yield, some information in here. I will create another one, still pasta. Pepe pasta. Okay, so I have two recipes here. We will see how to use it now with an API client. So here I can see on my API documentation that I can get my recipes, but it's only for the administrator. So if I use this client Bruno, my recipe app, I will just call it and we will see what we will have. Okay. Okay, so let's try. It is saying forbidden resource because, yeah, I didn't write any policy. So I will add now my policies here. I will just create, say that everyone can read my recipes. And let's try. Okay, now we have our recipe. So the first one, which is here, I will close it. And the second one, which is here. So the first one is called Cacio e Pepe Pasta. So we can see that we can get this list. And if I want to get just one recipe, it should work like that. Yes, so this is my recipe with the title, the description, the photo, everything here. If I go back on the list, maybe I close it quickly. Yeah, and I can see that I have my pagination. And that's it. We just saw how easy and fast it can be to have a fully functional backend for your application. And we just went over the surface. We can go much further with validation system, custom hooks, relationships between entities, file storage, and so on. And Manifest is open source. It's easy to self-host. We are working today on a cloud version for the future. And if you're interested in this cloud, just join the waitlist. I will put the link in the description. And I let you try it. If you like the project, just put a GitHub star, come to our Discord, join the community. If you like the tutorial, give it a like, and I will see you for another video. Cheers.